So, I gotta go to this interview today. It's for New York City Teaching Fellows, where anyone with a bachelor's degree can apply to try to become a teacher in New York City. So, I'm going to the interview for that, and I was preparing for that, and I have it today at like 4:15. Right now it's 12:47, so I still got like a few hours to prepare and then leave and go. And I'm trying to follow this kind of routine of shaving every day. And so I shaved today, and I was doing fine until the very last moment when I was putting my shaver away, and right as I was putting it away, it went psh. So right now I'm kind of bleeding right here. I cut myself right here, right as I was putting away the shaver. So just wanted to make a video of my clumsiness here. And it's a pretty big wide cut. It's bleeding quite a bit actually. So man, this is just bad. It's just really bad to be bleeding this bad like a few hours before the event. Yeah, I mean, but this week I've just been really bad with shaving. What was it like? I had an interview yesterday, and so just in case I you know, just trying to make sure that I don't cut myself that day while shaving, I shaved the day before. And when I did that, and this never happened to me before, I got a cut like right up there. It was very noticeable that day. I'm still bleeding. Yeah, so I was like, what the heck? What's going on? So apparently, like I'm usually good with shaving. I rarely cut myself, and I'm usually lazy with shaving too. So I usually like shave like every what like 4 days, and I grow this like long stash, and just like it looks ugly. I'm just like, all right, time to cut, time to shave, shh, away, and usually it's fine, but these days I'm trying to do more frequently, like every other day or every day, so that like I have this clean shaven look all the time. But man, it's turning out to be pretty disaster. Look at that, it's all very bloody right here. I'm trying to put pressure on it, but not working so far. So yeah. I don't know if it's just me, but I seem to be getting much worse at shaving. Even though I try to keep it simple, my dad told me to just shave straight down. Don't ever go side to side, just go straight down, down, down. Like make it simple, like simple short gestures so that you don't really cut yourself, and to do like short brushes. I try that, and it's been working really well, except just these past few days. Man, this one's really bad. I don't know when it's gonna heal. But yeah. So that's my video on that. This video can also act as like a channel update, I guess. I haven't made like a personalized video in a long while for YouTube. But I have to say, a lot has been going on, and I do plan on kind of making videos to kind of catch up on a bunch of stuff that has happened with me and a bunch of stuff that I'm planning to do. So definitely, wait for that. I don't know how long you would wait for that, but it's coming. Maybe a lot on like, 'cause my life right now is just pretty much just applying for jobs and interviews like crazy. Yesterday I had an interview, and I might actually do a video where I talk about the interview questions that were asked me, and I kind of like tell you guys how I answered the interview questions, 'cause I thought yesterday I did a pretty damn good job of the interview. I think it was my best interview I've done so far. And it's a dream job that I interviewed for yesterday. It's totally my field of work, and I think I would love what I would be doing there. The pay is terribly low, but really, my field isn't about pay. It's about helping other people working in nonprofits. So that's my field, and I hope I get it. But just in case I don't, is why I'm doing all this other interviews and stuff. Today's interview is New York City Teaching Fellows, which is very, very competitive. I hear like 1 in 10 applicants actually get accepted, advanced to the interview stage, which I have, and then 1 in 10 applicants in the interview actually get accepted. So it's a very competitive program, and I'm preparing for it now. I have to prepare a lesson plan. I have to prepare like I have to prepare all this material, and I have to go through a group interview session and a personal 30-minute interview session, one-on-one interview session. So definitely, I'm a little nervous. So maybe my nervousness is why I'm cutting myself accidentally. But I'll end this video on a really good note. As you can see, this tie is really cool. My dad called me today. I was taking a nap, and then my dad called me. I picked up the phone. I was like, "Hi, Dad." And my dad was like, "Yeah. So did you take all my ties from my home?" Because he lives in Tennessee. I was like, "Oh yeah. I just saw the on your tie rack, all those ties that looked good cool to me. I took them. So this is one of his ties. Yesterday, I used my dad's tie. I used this cool yellow tie yesterday for my dad. And like, he called me, he's like, "You should have told me that you took my tie." I was like, "Oh, I think I thought I did, but I'm sorry, but those ties were just too damn cool to not take." So yeah, I took my dad's ties. This is actually my dad's shirt. Like, my family, there's a lot of hand-me-down tradition going on. If I like a shirt that my dad wears, I take it. I'm his size. He's my size. He takes my shoes. He takes my socks. I take his, you know, so whatever. But apparently, one of his ties, this cool purple tie, I thought it was a really cool tie. I took it, and apparently this was actually my dad's. Someone gave it to him for a Christmas present this year, and I had no idea. I kind of feel like a jerk now, but yeah, I took all his ties, all his good ties. He told me, he's like, "All my good ties are missing." I was like, "Yeah, I just thought whatever looked cool to me, I just took." Didn't really know that he liked them as well. I guess my dad and I have similar tastes in ties. But yeah, I'll make a video after coming back home from the interview and tell you guys all about how I did in the interview and blah, 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 and stuff like that. Stay tuned.